I never thought about following in my father's footsteps musically. I just fell in love with music. I really work hard to not be an entitled individual, just for the sake of achieving things on my own. With music as a career, I guess, when I was 7 years old. I couldn't let it go. I was like, I have to play guitar, and I just started learning, and I finally worked up the balls to go out and play live. I started going on the road, and I started touring around and playing for people in clubs and wherever I could, but I'll admit, it wasn't getting any easier, and it's tough. Life on the road to that degree is hard. So I went ahead and went on reality television, which is just the last thing I ever saw happening with my career. And it won.
We are live in Los Angeles, ready to rock the cradle.
Congratulations, you have won Rock the Cradle.
You own that stage, you were strong, you commanded it.
I felt the passion that I know you're capable of. And tonight you reminded me why I fell in love with you.
For me, you were awesome. For you, you were awesome. For them, you were awesome. Way to rock it, way to come out of your comfort zone.
I know he's been a musician all his life, and it's... And the way we feel about it, it's led to this moment, and I think he deserves it.
You know, I believe in what I'm doing, and I'm just here being myself.
It was a total shock, and I found myself on Jive Records, the home of Britney Spears and Pink and R. Kelly, Justin Timberlake, and that was just the last label I ever saw myself finding my way to, and it was a whole new day. So I started writing with people like Cara DioGuardi, and... And John Mayer suddenly steps into my sessions and plays a solo on my title track of my record. And things like that just kind of started happening. And it was a total shock and a pleasant surprise after so many years of working so hard to finally get a little bit back.
Bouncing off the walls tonight, drunken heart, sunken eyes. It's 3 a.m. I'm tangled up over you.
There's really a lot of different ways to approach writing a song, whether it's just a lyrical idea or a melody. I think the best songs that I've ever written have just kind of flopped out in 15 minutes. That doesn't happen often enough, I think. So sometimes you gotta just throw it in the middle of the room and wrestle it to the ground like a bear. There's no other way to get it happening. But on this record, I did a lot of collaborating, and that was kind of a new experience. I wanted to push myself to get back to basics and see if I could write simpler songs than what I'd been writing. I also was really fortunate to write with Brett Denon, who had just finished a record with John Alasia at the Village where I was recording, and he was hanging around the studio a lot. And it's kind of like a frat house of music. It's like three stories of, you know, oh, hi, Seal, and there goes Heidi, and oh, Weezer's downstairs, and what, Ben Harper just stole our beer, and what's going on here? It's like a lot of camaraderie and a sense of community there that doesn't really exist in modern day recording studios. It's always, it used to a lot, but it's been scaled back so much now that there's always only one artist at a time in any given space. And to have that kind of back and forth between other engineers and other producers and other artists in the building, it was something I'd never experienced before.
It's like fame's like you're on a train or something. It just goes by and everybody's looking and they catch you in the window at that one moment. It's pure luck. So the person that's running around trying to be in the right window at the right time, a lot of times, is missing the point. And I'm not saying that I haven't done things in my life to get attention and to get my music heard, but when it comes down to it, the kind of music that I care about and the kind of music I make remains the same.
I want to get heard so I can bring to light the kind of things I have in my head and show people the music that I want to play for them. I have a lot of music in my head, and I want a chance to sing it for them. What people get from this record is some kind of reintroduction to the kind of music that I fell in love with when I was like 17 years old. I have a chance to express in myself in a way that a lot of people can come over, sit down, and take a breath, and give me a minute to show them what I got, because I got a lot. That's the deal.